Hey guys, Anders here. Welcome back to another video. So today, my first impressions after actually playing Battlefield 2042 Season 1, and I was right on some things, and I was presently surprised and mostly incorrect on other things. So we have some interesting things to go over for sure. As always, if you enjoy the video, hit the like button. Really does help the channel out, and be sure to subscribe to the channel if you want to keep up to date with Battlefield 2042, Modern Warfare 2, and other FPS games just like those. So, because I think a lot of people actually think I only make videos, and I only, quote-unquote, complain and whine in my videos, that's a very popular comment that I see very often from people that don't understand the difference between whining and opinionated discussion, let's go over the things that I was pleasantly surprised about first. Let's actually start directly with the map. Now, the map is actually, I think, pretty good. It might even be the best Battlefield 2042 base game map, and that is a massive surprise to me. With that being said, it is still too big in Conquest mode, but the saving grace of this map, at least a little bit, is the individual areas, the areas you get to fight in, are the best in the game, in my opinion. The flag areas are great. The routes are great. It's just there's a ton of wasted space, and that's what I predicted yesterday. I said that there would probably just be a bunch of wasted space. It would kill the flow of the map, and that is unfortunately what this map suffers from. But I think if they actually edit the conquest layout of this map, it could be pretty good. And Breakthrough, in my opinion, definitely is very, very good. There's a lot of routes. There's a lot of flank routes. There's a few really sneaky flank routes on the second or third sector where you can actually go above the sector, drop behind it, and you can potentially kill the whole team if you have a full squad of people. So I think Exposure is a pleasant surprise and a welcome addition to the game, but unfortunately, don't let that distract you from the fact that Season 1 is still completely underwhelming in terms of content. I would have really hoped for more maps with this content update, as I think many other people would. But there's no sense in hoping for what you will never get, so let's move on to some of the other things. I think I was actually completely correct with the Elevina lists, as some Polish native-speaking people pointed out in the comments section. It's Elevina, not Elowina, guys, so be careful. Lys's TV missile is just stupid, in my opinion. For starters, let's start with the fact that it regenerates the rockets you shoot. Have we learned nothing from the degeneracy that is Battlefield 4 UCAV spawn spamming? Have we learned nothing, DICE? Do you know what's going to happen? People are going to just sit in spawn or some safe location where you can't easily get to and just spam TV missiles, and that's all they're going to do. So they absolutely need to remove the fact that those missiles regenerate. On top of the fact that these missiles basically are completely uncounterable by tank players, and I feel the need to address this because I saw the misconception in the previous video by a ton of people that tanks are actually overpowered in Battlefield 2042, and I have to say, this is the very first time I've ever heard this, considering the tanks in Battlefield 2042, if you actually know what you're talking about, are the worst ever in Battlefield history, because the tank turret is nigh unusable, and they have no APS, no reactive armor, they're very slow, and it's honestly very difficult to actually hit anybody with the tank shell if you're not using heat. And the reason why people don't use the heat shell is because if you want to do actual damage to other tanks, you have to use the shell that is very hard to use, and you have to direct impact infantry to kill them. But because you have to direct impact them, and the tank turret is basically unusable, do you see where I'm going? Tanks are not overpowered. So if you hold that opinion, you are just wrong. Now, the reason why Lys is overpowered against tanks is she is essentially guaranteed damage that can be shot from 350 meters away with absolutely no counters, right? That is just ridiculous. But moving on, let's talk about the Battle Pass. The Battle Pass, it's all right. You know, I mean, it's just a Battle Pass. It's not really impressive. It's not disappointing, I guess. I'm okay with it. You know, whatever. Get some skins, get some titles, unlock some weapons and stuff, you know, whatever. It could be better, but it also could be worse, because this is DICE we're talking about. So let's just ignore the Battle Pass and just be thankful that it actually functions in-game. And as far as the weapons, I have actually not been able to use the weapons. I don't think I played enough to actually unlock any of them, so I will have videos out on the weapons later. And as far as the helicopters, apparently some of the stealth helicopters are allegedly insanely busted. We're talking like 100 kill games is a bad game type deal. So I can't wait to fully unlock all of the upgrades for the new helicopters and show you guys what those are like. But then again, with Lyssa's rocket, I have a feeling it's going to be pretty difficult to actually survive, because when I was playing today, let's just say that I couldn't go more than 2 steps without hearing or seeing a TV missile in the air. On top of the fact that Rao is completely and utterly overpowered as shit right now against vehicles, and if Rao decides you are not allowed to play the game as a vehicle, you are just simply not allowed to play the game as a vehicle. If you peek, you are hacked and you must leave. And then you peek again and he hacks you again and you must leave again. That is essentially how the gameplay goes if you're trying to play against Rao and you cannot kill him. So, all in all, Battlefield 2042 Season 1, the map is definitely the biggest surprise of all for me. The other stuff is fairly expected, but I am definitely surprised that the map is as good as I think a lot of people think it is, and particularly as good as I think it is, because I anticipated it to essentially just be, shall we say, barren wasteland, unplayable trash. So I am very happy to be proven wrong about that. That is excellent. Please, please fucking prove me wrong more, DICE. Please. That'd be great. It'd be fantastic. Prove the whole community wrong. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to the YouTube channel if you enjoyed the video. Leave a like on the video if you enjoyed it. And I will see you guys in the next one. Vehicle destroyed!